Hey guys, welcome back. So today is going to be my Sephora updates. I threw a little Ulta in here, a little drugstore, just the past two hauls that I have done. I have an equal amount of things that I love and things that I just do not like. That kind of surprised me because I thought that I would really like them, so it's kind of just bumming me out. So the first two things are e.l.f. I love these two items. Said that really weird. It is the bronzer palette, and I've been literally wearing this every single day, and it creates such a pretty tan. I don't know, I think this might be like $6. Totally worth it, and I think these pop out, so you could always, I don't know, maybe put like a Bobbi Brown shadow in there. That's the size of them, is pretty much like a Bobbi Brown shadow. So absolutely just have fallen in love with this bronzer palette. I think it's totally worth it. The Mad for Matte palette, it does not get any better than this for $10. All of these colors are super creamy. They blend really nicely. They're pretty warm. There's a few cool toned in here, so you can get a really nice neutral look, cool toned look, warm. I absolutely love this. So the one fail product for me that I don't really like the colors is this. It is the blush palette, and it's like for light skin. They're all really bright, and you have to have a really light hand with it. I do like this peachy shade right here. So out of the three, this is not my favorite, but I'm just gonna continue to wear it and try to work with it. But just for the sake of the video, I wanna just tell you that even though I haven't worn it that much, it's not my favorite. I wish the colors were a little bit lighter and not so bright. I'm not a huge bright blush type person. These two products I love. I don't want to go too much into this because you know that I love this product. It's the Born This Way foundation. It is by far my favorite foundation of life right now. I'm not joking. That's a pretty big statement because I have a lot of foundations. I am so blown out of the water with this. It covers everything. I think that's what I love most about it, is that it's full coverage but doesn't look like it's full coverage. It covers all of my acne scars, all of my scarring on my cheeks. It really perfects my skin, and for me it lasts a good solid 8 hours. I don't even need to powder. So I really love this foundation, and I'm so sorry that I ever doubted it. The product that I love to pair with it is the Marc Jacobs Coconut Primer. I really love this primer. I love how hydrating it feels on my skin. So I put it on and it's like an instant skin perfector. It doesn't necessarily blur all of my pores away, but it gives me really good hydration, and it's a very good primer for your foundation to kind of grab onto and last all day. It evens out my skin tone in a way where my skin's very illuminated after, so it just looks so nice. And I really love this stuff. I've been wearing a lot too. It is the Bronze Lights from Smashbox. This is a gorgeous, really light primer. A nice glowy bronze look, but without looking like you're wearing bronzer. Does that make sense? So it's great for like a setting powder. It's great for a bronzer. It doesn't overdo it. There's no like shimmer in it. It's virtually matte, and the color is just very nice. It's kind of just, it's definitely more warm than it is a cool toned bronzer, so you have to keep that in mind. It has some like yellow undertones to it, but it looks really nice, and it's great for like brightening the skin. But let's go on to Becca. I purchased a couple of things from Becca from Sephora, and I don't like them. Like, I don't. They're not for me. So the very first thing is Champagne Pop. I'm probably the only person on earth that did not care for this. Please, no death threats. I like more of a highlighter that's very subtle, that you can't tell that you're wearing highlighter, that it kind of mixes in with your skin's chemistry or your skin tone, and it just looks very illuminated. For me, this was a little bit too intense. I mean, I just don't like peachy highlighters. I just don't feel like they look natural enough for my skin tone because I'm so fair. And I felt like with this particular one, it didn't really blend very nicely with my skin tone. Maybe it's because I have dry skin, but I felt like the more I would blend it out, it just looked kind of patchy and drying on my face. So I'm gonna be returning this. I wanted to tell you guys that for my skin tone, I did not care for this highlighter. So take that for what it's worth. It probably works for you. It seems to work for everybody else under the sun. The next highlighter I want to talk about is the Laura Geller. This is actually a little darker, and what's funny about this one, and the reason why I like this one, is because it's so smooth when you blend it. Like, I could take my finger and just tap it on my cheekbones, and that it just totally blends so nicely. Like, you don't even need to use a brush. It gives such nice dimension to your cheeks. So if you're contouring and you want a really nice glowy highlighter, I would do this one. And since it is a gold highlighter, I feel like it blends in my skin more. Like, I did not think that I would like this, and I thought that I would like the Champagne Pop because this is darker and it's a little bit more yellow. So I'm like, there's no way it would work for my fair skin, maybe somebody darker. But it does, because I feel like it blends better into my skin than this one does. It looks like it's kind of part of my skin versus she's wearing a highlighter. I can kind of see it in my pores. It's kind of accentuating rough texture and pores, that type of thing. So that is why I prefer this one over the Champagne Pop. The only reason why I didn't like this product is because of the highlighter. The highlighter I felt looked really pasty under my brow bone. It didn't blend very nicely. I actually liked the color of the mousse for my brows, but when I applied it, it didn't apply as smooth as my IT Cosmetics. I wish I liked it. I really want to like it. I really wanted to like it. It's just the concealer part of it just kind of ruined it for me, honestly. Speaking of highlighters that absolutely leaves me dead in my tracks, it's the NARS Tribulation. I have not been so obsessed with something in my entire life, and that's probably why everything else pales in comparison. I'm actually going to get a backup. This is one of those products that you can put it all over your face and it looks like you have a youthful glow, like you just got a facial. I have it on my cheeks today. I have it freaking all over my face, and it just makes you look like you left like the spa and you had a facial. Your face is glowy, it's dewy, there's no glitter to it, there's no frost. It is like rose gold heaven. There is something, NARS just absolutely knocked it out of the park with this one. I am so impressed. And like I said, I'm gonna get a backup, like stat. Out of all of the NARS products, you have got to try this one. It is totally 100% worth the money. The Kat Von D Bow and Arrow. I am not a lipstick person. I don't know why I continue to buy them hoping that I'll like it. This is the thing about this. I love the color. I love the shade once it applies, but as you wear it, it gives you the worst, like, dry mouth. Like, your lips are so dry that it's hard to talk. Like, you're constantly, like, licking your lips and it settles into all of your cracks. I don't know. Like, when people say that it doesn't settle into your lines and that it stays smooth all day, they're totally lying, because it does. Unless you wear maybe a liner or a gloss with it, but if you wear it just on its own, it's not the most forgiving liquid lipstick. Like, it's gonna accentuate your lines. It's gonna kind of crack right here, looking very dry. And it's just not a soft matte product. It's just not. I love the color. I'm gonna keep it anyway because I do love the color, and I'm just not gonna purchase any more. I think I am done in the liquid lipstick department. The Lorac Pro Matte Lip Colors. These are another one that I'm gonna keep because I love the shades so much, but they also kind of dry out my lips as well. As the day goes on, you can wear them for the first hour or so, they look great, but as the days goes on, it becomes less and less comfortable to wear. So speaking of something that is very comfortable on the lips and that I can wear all day is the Urban Decay Revolutionary Matte. Is that how you say it? The Revolution Matte. This is in Stark Naked. I'm wearing it. I love this. All day comfortable wear. Like, you can feel almost, even though it's matte, you can feel kind of a slip to your lips. It's not sticky, so you can talk. You don't feel like you're stumbling over your words. It lasts all day. You can drink, you can eat. That's one of the things with the other thing, with the other products that I didn't like, is that after about a couple of minutes, the slip wears off and it sets, but it sets in a very drying, sticky form. So as you talk, you feel like you have to lick your lips or that you have to like throw on some lip balm or something. It's just not comfortable. Like, it just is not. I love the liner as well as the lipstick. They both go hand in hand and they both are very creamy and smooth to wear. Great job, Urban Decay. I absolutely love this. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think below, and I will see you next time. Bye.